Today we're going to repair a damaged barrel mainspring. These are the tools you will need. Some files, smooth jaw pliers, tin snips, flame gun, butane, masking tape, biro or a pencil, small vise, and a hole punch set. Okay, let's get started. This is a mainspring we're going to repair. You can see it's cracked either side and has got a bit of a lip on it here. That's waiting to break inside a barrel and destroy some of your wheels when that snaps. Now, first thing we do, tear off some masking tape. Place it on the back of the spring, lining up one edge accurately, and press it down. So that when you turn it over, you can see where the hole is. Now, taking your biro or pen, trace round the hole in the spring two or three times so that it's quite distinct. Now, remove the masking tape and put it aside. Now, with the tin snips, come up about 6 mil or of a quarter of an inch above the top of the hole and cut a straight line across the spring, or more or less a straight line. Now, having recovered the bit that just jumped onto the floor, we'll tear off another piece of masking tape. We'll place it over the end of the spring where we've just cut it off and push it down flat. Take another piece of masking tape and placing the end that we just cut off over the top of the tape. We'll tape it down with the other piece of masking tape, making sure that the end lines up neatly. Now, taking your pen or pencil, trace around the old end of the spring. Now remove the masking tape and the end of the old spring. Which then leaves you with a template to the end of the new spring. Now, using the tin snips, carefully cut along the line that you have just drawn. To give you a general shape of the end of the spring. We'll file that neatly later, but at the moment that's all we need for that. Now, remove the masking tape and we're ready for the next part of the operation, which is annealing the spring. That's the rough end now that we've cut it. Now collect your masking tape that's got the template hole on it. Line up the smooth side and press it down onto the spring, making sure that it's in the middle. Grab your pen and outline the hole that we marked before, assuming your pen's going to work for you, so that it is easier to see. Okay, next step. We need to draw a line in the center of both radiuses so we know where to put the punch. There we have it. Now we select the correct hole size by lining the punches up on the diagram we've drawn and making sure that it fits inside the drawing completely. Right, that's the first one. It's 5/32 of an inch. We'll put this into the punch. Got him. Screw that back in again. Now we have to put the corresponding base on. 5/32. That one. Okay, we screw that in. Oops, the correct way would probably be a good idea, so that it just comes up above the level of the punch, like so. You can see it moving in and out. That's about correct. The punch goes down, that'll punch that out beautifully. Now, we now align the punch on our hole that we have drawn on the template. Hold it there, check it both ways to make sure that it's right. When you're sure it's right, squeeze the punch. And it's done. There's a hole. This can also be done on a drill press, but make sure that you hold the mainspring very tightly clamped down or it'll move. Okay, we need the next hole, and it's a larger one, so we'll replace the 5/32 of an inch punches and look for the next size that we require. It's that. Now, back to our spring again. You'll see that the radius at the top is larger than the last one. So we'll start looking to see what size we need. We'll check the next one. I think that's the one, but let's see. Yes. No, that's all right. We'll use that punch. The hole at the bottom is always larger than the top one, so that can easily catch in the hook of the barrel. That's 7/32. Line the punch. The bottom part of your template and align it. It's not easy to do and it takes time, but it's got to be placed correctly. That's in the center. And the center of the line we put there, remember, to align it. So that's all right. Okay, once that's right, close the punch and open it up. That's the two holes that we're going to use.